Right, I'm back with part two of looking at the fruits and how people will recognize your fruits. As I was saying before in Luke 6, it says, "Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and you do not do what I say? I will show you what he has like who comes to me and hears my words and puts them into practice. Do you put what the Lord has said to you, what Jesus Christ says that his Father has said to do the will of God, to do good, to help people? And by the fruits of a person, it will show whether you store good things in your heart or whether you're an evil man and you store evil in your heart, and through the overflow of your heart storing these things, it will come out of your mouth." Other words, in the worldly saying, is action speaks louder than words. And I suppose action, in a sense, is like faith. If you have faith in God, then you will do good things, and good things will overflow out of your heart and out of your mouth. But if you are not following the will of God and you're not doing what God says, then you are building up evil things in your heart and it will overflow out of your mouth. Other words, in the worldly sense, yes, action speaks louder than words. An action is like, I have the faith to do what God says, and I have the faith to believe in that, and I believe in God, I believe in Jesus Christ, and I have the faith not to live by sight, but to live by faith. See, he says in verse 47 of Luke 6, verses 47, he says, he is like a man, 47, I will show you what he is like, who comes to me and hears my words and puts them into practice. He gives the example here. He is like a man building a house who has dug down deep and laid the foundations of a rock. When a flood came and the torrent struck the house but could not shake it because it was well built. See, at the end of the day, somebody, as I was saying to you before, if a person is of good, it says in verse 45, the good man brings good things out of good stored up in his heart, and the evil man brings evil things out of the evil stored up in his heart, for out of the overflow of his heart is his mouth speaks. So someone that is a good man will bring good things out of that is good, that is stored up in his heart, that is good. And see, out of his goodness and what he stores up in his heart that is goodness will overflow out of his mouth. So in a sense, yes, we can put that into context, that in verses 49, but when one who hears my words does not put them into practice is like a man who built his house on the ground without foundation. So in these two contexts here, in verses 48, is like the man building a house who dug down deep and laid the foundations on the rock. So the person that dug down the foundations and dug down deep and put the foundations into the rock of solid did not end up having his house destroyed or have destruction, because he has a good heart, and out of his good heart overflows out of his mouth the goodness and the fruits. And out of the fruits we can see what sort of person this person is. We can see through the fruits of this person who this person is. But an evil person, someone that is not doing the will of God and that is not doing what God commands us to do, then obviously in the other example of verse 49, the one who hears my word but does not put them into practice is like a man who built his house on the ground without foundation. The moment that the torrent struck, the house collapses and its destruction was complete. So other words, you know, in verses 45, or Luke 6, verses 45, it says here, and the evil man that brings evil things out of the evil stored up in his heart, and for out of the overflow of his heart his mouth speaks. See, We can see in verses Luke 6 verse 49, but the one who hears my word does not put them into practice is like a man who built his house on the ground without foundation. The moment the torrent struck the house, it collapses and the destruction is complete. So in other words, we want to hear God's word. We want to do God's will. We want goodness in our hearts. We want the overflow of the goodness of our hearts to come out of our mouth of the goodness things and saying of good things, not of evil things, because that is not of God and that is not of Jesus. We don't want to be like the evil man, because he stores evil in his heart, and out of the overflow he he speaks evil things and says things which we can then, as I was saying, we can see the fruits. We can see the fruits of the good man, and we can see the fruits of the evil man, or the man that obviously is doing evil. I don't mean evil in such as it's so bad, bad, bad. But obviously, looking at the scriptures here, this is how it's being put down to context. So we have two things here. Number one, if you are doing good, and in Luke 6 verses 45, the good man brings good things out of the good stored up in his heart. So the good man brings good things out of the good stored up in his heart. And obviously then we go on a little bit further down. For out of the overflow of his heart, his mouth speaks good things. And so if we go down to verses 48, he is like the man building a house who dug down deep and laid the foundations on the rock. When the flood came, the torrent struck the house, but could not shake because it was well built. You know, you are well built. You have the foundation. You build your foundation on the rock, because the fruits that people can see is that you have built your foundation on the rock. You have built your foundation on the rock, and you have built a well-built structure around yourself, because the things of your heart are stored up of good things, and out of your mouth there is good things. And if we put this into more context, then as in the worldly senses, action speaks louder than words. Just like if you put faith into action, out of faith you have an action, and out of an action in God's will, and you're doing God's will, anything in God will be done. Nothing's impossible in the sight of God. The things of this world are impossible, but the things of God are possible and will be done, because it is God's will. But see, then if we look at the second one, so really at the end of the day, where would you want to be? I mean, I'd rather want to be the person that is following God's will, reading the Bible, praying every day, and doing everything that God says to do, and bearing good fruit. See, each tree is recognized by its own fruit. People do not pick figs from the thorn bushes or grapes from briars. See, if we go on, as we're saying in Luke 6 verses 45, it goes on to say, and the evil man brings evil things out of the evil stored up in his heart, for out of the overflow of his heart the mouth speaks. So the evil man that stores up evil things in his heart, it will overflow out of his mouth. And so that means in verses 49 it says, but one who hears my words and does not put them into practice is like a man who built his house on the ground without foundation the moment the torrent struck, and the house has collapsed and its destruction was complete. If you do not follow God, and you do not follow the will of God, and you do not accept Jesus Christ in your heart, and you want to follow the world, obviously we can see from the worldly sense that it only leads to destruction, and we are actually building and being deceived, because we're building our house on the sand, and we are not building our house on the rock and on a solid foundation. So there are two things here tonight. The two things here tonight is, we want to have the first thing, and the first thing is to have a good heart. To have a heart that is of good, and that does good, and bears good fruit. And out of your heart, the overflow, it comes out of your mouth, the good things. You know, because I will go on to sermon 2 in a minute, sermon 3, sorry, of the fruits, and I'm just going to leave it there for a second. But also what I'm saying, there are two things, the two things that I've spoken, having a good heart or having an evil heart. So I'm going to leave it there, and I will go to sermon 3 of the fruits just in a minute.